Hey everybody, it's Lavender Town.
And as some of you might know already, long before I was on YouTube, I was making comics. I have been making and posting comics online for many, many years now, and it's one of my ultimate passions in my life. However, recently, I have been having a really hard time keeping my comic updated because I just have so much other stuff to do with YouTube and everything else. So I wanted to make a video talking about some of the things that I'm doing and changing so that I can draw faster, and I thought maybe some of you guys need to draw faster too. My very first tip does apply to this situation, but it also is kind of my strategy to fixing any problem that I'm having, and that is to figure out the source. If you feel like you're drawing slower than you used to, there's probably a reason for that, and figuring out what that is going to help you fix the problem and make yourself faster. So, if you're, like in my case, suddenly realizing that you seem to be drawing slower, try to figure out what caused that. In my case, at first I thought it was just because I was very busy, I was trying to do more YouTube than I'd ever done, but when I really sat down and thought about it, I was able to update Unfamiliar twice a week when I was super busy in school, I had super long art classes and a job on the weekends, and I still managed to do 2 pages a week, so I knew that that wasn't the problem, something else was wrong. And then I looked back at those pages that I had been able to do during school and I realized one of the biggest changes. My average panels per page was only 4 to 5 when I first got started, but recently, over this past year, my pages routinely have 8 or more panels per page. So if you feel like you suddenly slowed down, try to look back at the art that you used to do faster and see if it's drastically different. In my case, I had subconsciously doubled my workload without even noticing it, so obviously that's going to slow you down. Now some of you are going to be saying, I don't feel like I've gotten slower, I feel like I've always been slow, and in that case, this tip is for you. So this next tip I have for you is to try to manage your perfectionism. This is something that is very, very difficult for us artists. A lot of people have a really hard time not over-rendering and basically really, really obsessing over every little detail of what you're drawing. But depending on what you're doing, and especially if you have a deadline, sometimes that can be really, really bad. It seems like it's a really good habit to try and make your art perfect, but sometimes if you find yourself drawing the same line over and over and over again because it's just not quite right, sometimes you should just stop and move to the next part of the drawing and know that you can erase it later if it's really going to keep bugging you. But a lot of the times when I find myself stuck on one part of the drawing, once I move away from it, it doesn't look as bad to me anymore. Sometimes you just need to step away from your work and give yourself a breather, because if you get stuck in this like perfectionism loop, that can really, really slow you down. It also just makes it a lot less fun. My third tip is to focus on what's actually important. A lot of the times when you're drawing, you can get caught up in little details and things that you struggle with that aren't even really the point of the drawing. Hands are a good example of this, but it can really be anything that's a weakness of yours. Now obviously you want to work on that weakness, but you don't have to do it in every single drawing. If you really hate drawing hands, it's stressing you out and it's taking up all your time, just do some more cartoony hands. I mean, I'm one of the biggest advocates for making your art work for you. And if something is just like no fun for you to draw and you hate it and it takes up all your time, then just adapt, like change it to be something that works more for you. Now, some of you are not in a position to change your style whenever something's frustrating you. So, for example, if you're in art school or you're doing client work where somebody is expecting a specific style from you, obviously that tip's not going to work. So my tip for you, if you're busy working either student or a professional, if you're having a hard time getting things done and you're realizing that you're slowing down, it's probably because you're not taking enough breaks. A lot of the times when you have specific deadlines and things expected of you, you don't take breaks and you just like sit down and work without stopping for a long time, and that can feel very productive, but in reality, after a few hours of working, you're gonna start getting less and less productive because you're just putting too much fatigue on your body. So if you just get up from your chair, drink some water, walk around, maybe jog in place and stretch your hand, that's actually going to make back those 15 minutes you took on the break over the amount of time that you're drawing, because the fatigue that you feel will make your work more shaky and you're gonna have to keep like fixing things over and over again just because you're so worn out. Also, that's just generally a good habit to get into, especially if you're a busy student or a professional, you're probably drawing a lot. And if you get in the habit of giving yourself occasional breaks, it's going to improve your health and your happiness in the long run, so that's also really important. My next tip is to experiment with different types of drawing tools. So sometimes people draw in materials that make them slower. A good example of this is, say, a paint that has to dry, or drawing in a computer that's very slow that can't handle your drawing program. These types of things require you to have these waiting periods, and obviously over a long period of drawing in them, those little waiting periods add up to hours and hours of potential work time that was wasted. So if you're someone who really wants to speed up your drawing process, you should seriously consider looking at the way that you draw and seeing if there's any spaces where wasted time could be removed by just changing what you're drawing with. A great example of this is, rather than using like a dip ink pen that needs to dry, try using like a technical pen, like a Micron. Microns have brushes and all kinds of different widths that you can use, and they dry instantaneously, so you're not going to have to wait for that ink to dry. If your computer is running slow when you draw on it, it might be your drawing program. It's at least worth experimenting with other lighter drawing programs and seeing if that helps. I definitely know that when I was working on my older laptop, Photoshop made it slow down like crazy, and some other programs did not. So if you can just work with a lighter weight program, it will take you a little time to learn that new program, but in the end you'll end up saving a lot of time if your computer can run it more easily. This isn't really a tip to make your drawing faster, but this is a good way to sort of optimize your overall life. If you have multiple different drawings that you have to do for whatever reason, try to see if you can combine them into like a multi-purpose drawing, if that makes any sense. So, for example, when I was in art school, sometimes my assignments kind of correlated with comic work, so I would turn in my comic pages as an assignment, which would allow me not only to keep up with my updates, but also to keep up with my schoolwork. It reduced my workload, but ended up giving me more time to put more quality into both, because they were now the same project, rather than having to do a half-hearted job on both my school assignment and my update, or having to choose one over the other. I don't know how many of you are in a position where you're having to draw a lot of specific different drawings, but if you're in art school, that's definitely something that I recommend. I also sometimes do that for my YouTube. Oftentimes I want to make stuff that's just for you guys and keep everything separate, but sometimes, like when I do some of my character designs, those used to correlate with school assignments as well, or with a character design that I wanted to get done, but I didn't know how I was going to do it, and realizing that I could also make it a video gave me the sort of like mental permission to actually sit down and spend time on that character design. So anytime that you can sort of make something dual purpose, I highly recommend trying that. Another tip I have, and this is if you find out that one of the sources of your slowing down is because you're getting distracted, a lot of the times that's because you're listening to the wrong stuff while you work. A lot of artists I know don't just sit in a quiet room and draw with nothing distracting them. A lot of us try to listen to something or watch something at the same time. Now, I used to try to watch TV shows while I drew, and that definitely made me a lot slower. It was a weird habit I got into during art school. I was like pretty bored a lot of the times. I was just drawing like all day every day, so I'd end up watching reruns of shows I'd already seen, and I thought it would be fine because I'd already seen them, but the visual elements of a TV show makes it very hard for you to focus on the visual stuff that you're trying to draw. So I recommend, if you're the type of person who likes to leave Let's Plays on in the background, or like TV shows or anything like that, movies, try switching to music or podcasts for a little while. Music is the best. Podcasts are really good too. Just see if that helps you. It might not help you. It might not be necessarily going to speed you up, but if that is your problem, that is a really easy fix and something that I recommend trying. And if none of these tips sound particularly helpful, if you don't think that it's your materials and you don't think that it's your perfectionism, if you genuinely just think that you're being slow, the last thing that you can do is just try to practice. Honestly, when you first start drawing, or even for the first few years, drawing is a very, very slow practice. And even a lot of people who do this professionally spend hours and hours and hours and hours on a single drawing. So you should also check and make sure that you're not holding yourself to too high of a standard. It's okay to spend a lot of time on art. It's really important, and you don't want it to be something just like sloppy and slapdash. You want it to be good. So there's really nothing wrong with being a little slow, as long as you're still able to reach all your deadlines. And especially if you don't have any deadlines, like, you shouldn't be forcing yourself to be significantly faster. The most important thing is that you continue enjoying drawing, and that you continue just trying to be a better and better version of the artist that you want to become. Thank you so much to my wonderful patrons, including Bella Story, Blue Boy, Kalpumpong, Clockwork Construct, Dionysus Hadrilis, Dr. Casket, Elizabeth Album, Imagine Creations, JJ Jade, Joseph Copel, Justin, Carla Tapia, Katie Marigold, Kierdider, Kyle D. Metz, Le Blah Blah Blah, Midnight Doodles, Micah Dactyl, Musa Deer Rachel, Nora Cornielsen, Okamore, Ollie, Rosie Warlock, Sergeant Pendulum, The Artsy Moose, Your Boy ST, and Zoe Stardust.